Morning children, today we are going to start our physical education class. That is a chapter 1, human anatomy. So under that, in the previous class we have discussed about the spine cord in the human anatomy, and we saw the different parts, regions and the vertebrates of each regions and their special characteristics. So now in today's class we will see the hip girdle. Okay, so now we are coming to that. Is so commonly known as hip bones. So they are attached to the axial skeleton. Now what is an axial skeleton? So there are two types of skeleton. So one is an axial skeleton and appendicular skeleton. So axial skeleton means the bones of the skull till the spinal cord. We call it as a axial skeleton. So under that we have a three parts now. In the hip bones, one is the ilium, then pubis and cecium. So now this bones helps us to protect the organs. So what are the organs? The organs will internal organs will be very soft, so they have to protect from the other environmental conditions. So this pelvis protect us the organs. What are the different organs? Like urinary bladder, then part of the large intestines, they are very soft. So this pelvis protects the this kind of organs. So now let us see the pictorial representation. So here you can see all the three types of this bone. So this we call it as a ilium, which protects us from all the other activities. This is a hip bone, then last one is the pubis. Okay, large bones, the bones which are large here, this bone and this one, they are heavy and attached to the axial skeleton. So they are attached again, the spinal cord get attached here, so they are attached. Okay, this large bones and the pelvis, this is a pelvis. Okay, the entire thing we call it as a pelvis, which supports and protects the reproductive organs, urinary bladder and large intestine. Okay, so next we come to hind limbs. So these limbs, they carry the total body weight. So total the body weight depends upon the hind limbs, and their body is erected, right? We stand straight, we bend with the lower limbs. Okay, this is due to the hind limbs, which carries the total body weight. Again, there are different parts in that hind limb. So what are that? Femur, we have two in number. So you'll see that in the diagram. And it is the strongest and heaviest bone in the body. This femur, we have two, that is two legs from that. I'll show it in the diagram. Which is strongest and heaviest bone apart from all the bones in the body. So now when coming to the upper end, so it is a ball like structure. We'll see the diagram. So you can see the upper part. So this is a femur, which has got a head, neck and lesser throat. So this is an upper part which is like a ball like structure and which is attached to the hip bone. So already we saw the pelvis there. It is this ball like structure is attached to this socket. So like this you can see here. So first one is a femur, right? So this is a large bone in the body. How many femurs we have? This is one and this is one. And this ball-like structure is attached to this pelvis, right? Two things. So this particular joint at which the both the femurs are attached, this and this, we call it as a hip joint. Okay. So next, the second part is kneecap. You can see that is a patella, or we say it as a kneecap. So how many numbers are there? Two. So they are long and cylinder. You can see from outer side the lower leg. So they are joined here. Next we have a tibia. So this one. So it is a also called as a shin bone. It is larger and medial. You can see the two here. Okay. Next we have tarsals, that is 14 in number. So this joints from the feet till the toes. So how many joints are there? There are 14 joints are there. They are also called as an ankle bones. So they make, what are the things that they cover? They cover heel, half upper of the foot, so they cover heel, upper part of the foot, and there are two largest tarsals. Okay, then we have metatarsals, 10 in number. So how many fingers we have? 10 fingers. So there will be 10 metatarsals. So each foot consists of 5 fingers. So totally it is 10. Next we have phalanges, that is 28 numbers that attach to the bones and the hands. Hands we saw in the toe there are 3 phalanges. You can see here in the fingers, joints. So totally there are 3. If you calculate, it will be 28. So the toes and the fingers will be having the same number of phalanges. Okay, it has 3 phalanges and the greater toe has 1. So here greater toe has 1. Remaining 4 toes will be having 3. Greater will be having 2. Okay. So next let us see what are the functions of the skeleton system. So how does the skeleton support our body? So it is a framework. So without the bones, the body will not get a shape and will not have a strength. So it is like a steel girdle for our bodies, which supports the body and give us a particular shape to our body. So that is the first function of this skeleton system. Then next one is the movement. So we have two types of skeletons here. One is the tendons and the skeleton muscles. So tendons, they all the organs will be attached to that particular bone, so that from that we can move. For example, hands are attached to the tendons along with the skeletal muscles. Muscles will be attached so that we can move from one place to another. Next is the protection of vital organs. What are the vital organs? Like heart, kidney, lungs, urinary bladder, brain. So all this we call it as a vital organs. So those organs it will protect. Otherwise what happens? The organ may get damaged. So it helps in the protection of these organs from the damage. So next is a mineral storage. So bones contains act as a reservoir of so many minerals. So what are minerals? Like phosphorus, then calcium. So the bones, especially the bone, stores 99% of the calcium. So if you does not have any food, or if you not eat a food, what happens? Where does the energy comes from? So bones will be storing the such kind of minerals. So we will get an energy from the bone. So next is again from the skeleton, that is from the blood marrow. What happens? Blood cells are formed. So secretion of blood happens in the bone marrow. So these are the functions of the skeletal system. Okay. So next we will see the classification of different types of joints.